I'm back out. I have another itch to scratch. It sounds like I got a skin condition, doesn't it? I've got something to show you as well in this video, but I'm not going to show you it out in the woods. I will preempt what I got to show you, and it is another stove, special one this time though, and a very old one, and I'll tell you a bit about that when I get home. But this is about scratching an itch, and it's going to be photography related. Photography for me is something I've had an interest in going back to my childhood, but I've never really properly bit the bullet with it, and by that I mean I've never really had expensive high quality cameras or lenses, and I've never really had my hands on with regarding sort of editing the photographs to bring the best out of the best out from what the camera takes. And to do that, that means taking your photographs in a raw format, which is basically the sort of the raw data that the sensor captures really, and then manipulating it in a very good quality editing suite like Lightroom or Photoshop. God, it's so wet again. Look at this, look. Also, this is Wiltshire. This has been filmed during the sort of lockdown of February 2021, for anyone that's watching it in the future. So, you know, I've got to make the best of what I'm able to do, and that means you can't travel far from home, and there's no, it's this particular area where I live on the outskirts of Swindon isn't known for its photographic beauty for want of a better term, you know. So I gotta do what I gotta do, and you know, here I am at the age of 58, having had an interest in photography and video making for most of my life, and I'm not really grown much. Let's say I've not really grown much beyond that of a keen beginner really, and that's about the level I put myself at. So the main subject of this video is this beautiful stove that I've got, this very old beautiful stove that I've got, that I'm not going to show you out here in the woods, but this being an outdoor type channel, I feel that I've got to put something, no, I don't feel I've got to, I feel I want to put something of an outdoor nature up, and perhaps capture in a few photographs the woodland, the outdoors. At this time of year, it's bleak, it's cold, but it's all part of nature, you know, and I feel I've got to capture that, do it justice, then I'll show you my stove. Walked in to the piece of the woodland that's always, I've walked into this area loads of times, and I've always sort of thought there's a photograph here. There's so much here to photograph, or there is a photograph here, but I don't know if I can bring it out. I don't know if I can do it justice. It's finding that composition, and then using framing the shot and then using this Lightroom to see if I can make it into something, but I don't know. I think it's harder than I think. I like that tree. I like this tree here as it's fallen down. But no doubt the professionals would say that's no good because it's got the bird seed where people have been feeding the birds on it and stuff like that, and it's so busy, there's such a lot happening. May not be such an easy place to take a photograph. Stump, look, that's a lovely photograph, look, Carmen on a stump. What do you reckon then, Carmen? Do you reckon we're a good team? Do you reckon we'll find a nice photograph? Eh? What do you reckon then, eh? What do you think? You like it here, don't you? Yeah, she's enjoying herself. Are you enjoying your walkie? Yeah, she's enjoying her walkie. It's cold though, isn't it? Let's get snapping. I took some woodland shots. I'll tell you what though, it's a lot harder. It's a lot harder when you're actually out there and you're trying to find that elusive composition. Anyway, I'm going to walk on now to the parkland. There's a lovely lake and a few other things which might be worth taking a photograph of. There's an old folly actually, so I might take a picture of that as well. And then we'll make our way back home. Well, I'll show you this lovely old stove. I think half the problem with me and photography is that I think I see too much. I always, whenever I come out into the woods or into nature, I always sort of see loads of lovely images, but when you try and sort of crop that into what a camera sees, it's that's the skill. And I don't think I got it, to be honest with you. Or if I, well, no, that's being too harsh on myself. It's a skill which you learn. Dog's really behaving herself. I haven't got to worry about her. She just follows me. For those of you that have just joined my channel, you won't know about my other little dogs I used to have, Jessie and Elsa. Elsa in particular, she was a lovely little dog. I often walk miles and not even think about where my dog was. And she'd always be within a few hundred yards of me. This one, I think it's going to be the same. Never goes too far.
Carmen.
A bit of dog communication going on just then, I think. Right, I'm just walking up to the lake. This is always a good test subject for a photograph because there's a lot of sky you can capture in this picture. A lot of water, reflections, etc, etc. So I have taken this picture before, but I've never been able to use it in Lightroom to sort of adjust the values, etc, to make it look pretty. So we'll see, here's the water. Carmen. Now I know there's going to be some of you looking at my images and being critical and saying, oh, that's no good. I can see where people have walked. I can see he's got twigs and rubbish in here and there. You just got to bear in mind that these are my, I'm the beginner at this really. That's the level that I'm at. So I think we can say that in all honesty, things can only get better. But unless you go out and try these things, you know, and try and work on your desires and ambitions in life, you're never going to improve, are you? I can see pictures everywhere, but none of them are going to make masterpiece compositions. Anyway, my dog. She's such a good girl. Come here. Oh,
say hello to the camera. You're a good girl, aren't you?
She's been absolutely beautiful, wonderful. Very obedient, stays close to me all the time. I know she's feeling the cold now, and I think she wants to go home. I want to go home, I want that cup of tea. Hey, look at their feet. You know, this way. Come on, let's go this way. This way, sweetheart. Come on, we'll go this way. A few hours ago, before I came out, I was sat at home, had my breakfast, looking out the window, thinking to myself, no, it's no good. Light's not right, it's cold, it's windy, it's horrible. I'm so pleased I got out. Okay, I took some photographs, probably no good. But I did it. I went out, I took some photographs, and I got out and got the fresh air. I got the exercise, dog got a lovely walk. It's just a win-win. Always a win-win when you can get out. Anyway, we are heading back home now. And then I'll show you that lovely old stove. As you can see, I'm back home. In my lovely warm kitchen, and there's the stove. Now this was rebuilt by my friend Cameron. He even sent it back in a little bag with a note. Dear Sandy, I hope this stove gives you the same pleasure as it gave me to fettle it. Yours, Cam. Thanks, Cameron. Here it is, 1936. It's, what's that make it? That makes it 85 years old. So that makes the stove around about 85 years old. It used to belong to Tom Withers, G3HGE, who's now sadly a silent key. And it is a Primus number 96. I learnt something about Primus. I learnt about why they're called Primus. Well, Primus, apparently Prime or Primus is number one, is the first. So they were, Primus was the first to come up with this idea of a pressurised stove. So anyway, let's assemble the stove. It's got a brand new lead washer in the base. Cam's done something to the pump. This is called a lipstick, and he's put a new lipstick and new gauze in there. There's every chance this stove is going to be around again in another 85 years, though it'll probably by then need fettling again. I've got to put that on. That's to
preheat the vaporizing tube. Then you've got the rose, and then a flame spreader made in Sweden. Primus are apparently the best ones. This is simply a windshield, I believe, to go around there like that. Let's put the pot supports on, get some paraffin in the stove and get it lit. I mean, this to me, this looks like a proper stove. This is how a stove should look. I think, is it a light? Oh, it is now. And then we'll just warm the vaporizer up. This just equalises the pressure in the fuel reservoir, so that's that can be nipped up now. And we'll just give it a minute or two to warm up. It's starting to make a roaring sound, and I haven't even pressurised it. Oh, I think it's going. It is. Cam said he put a new pump washer and a new valve in there. I tell you, it pumps beautifully. Wonderful, that was brilliant. So obviously just by releasing the pressure in the tank, it just kills the stove. So there you go, an 85 year old camping stove. We think it dates from about 1936. There's a couple of letters on the base of the tank which tell you the date approximately. Quite collectible now. And hopefully good for another 85 years of service. And as you can see, makes a cracking cup of tea.